Hello, basketball fans. You've got it on 2K Sports as we get set to bring you an exciting NBA basketball game. I'm Kevin Harlan, joined by Chris Webber and Greg Anthony. David Aldridge is our sideline reporter. For the Portland Trail Blazers, they won their last contest, that game against the Timberwolves. It was just a textbook performance. That game was all theirs. Once they got it going, it was full speed ahead.
And this is why scouting is so important. You've got to be able to identify those role players who can complement what your team does.
Yeah, that was big-time production from the bench, especially on the offensive end.
Now let's send it down to David Aldridge, standing by from the sidelines. David?
Well, guys, undisputedly, Damian Lillard is the leader of this Blazers team. Now, Yusuf Nurkic said, "He's the best thing that's happened to me. To have a superstar in this league as a leader, a friend, and a teammate, it makes me better." Kevin?
LDA, you can't get much higher praise than that. Thanks. And, you know, Chris, it's early, of course, but a few veteran players seeing dips in their individual production. And there has been some talk. There has been some concern about that.
Yeah, but even for veterans, it could take a while to get into a groove. It's the beginning of the season. You still have to find your way, new teammates, new concepts. And
right.
If a player's role on the team has changed,
boys,
that can
nice
affect
night.
His production. I mean, look at a guy like Melo last year, going to a different situation. Do you sacrifice by shooting less? Do you sacrifice by shooting more? Because some guys are out of position, out of sorts, and out of their comfortable areas or their comfortable norms of playing. And so, yeah, it takes a lot, whether you're a rookie or a veteran. It really doesn't matter. This game can throw monkey wrenches at you in all type of areas, and it's how you adjust. So it's not about the start. It's how you identify what you need to do to get better, and then do it, and then see how that adjustment is going.
Yeah, Anthony's a good example. You're right. All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. Setting the floor for the Bucks. Giannis is down low with Lopez. Bledsoe is out there with Malcolm Brogdon, and it's Middleton in at the three. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Chris Middleton. That is his first foul of the game. Here's Lillard, and the rebound goes to Lopez, and it's Milwaukee's ball. It's a three-point game. This game coming on the heels of their win against the Kings.
And once they established that flow offensively, really never got any resistance from the D.
And I feel like the defense was one step behind all night. I mean, they never made the adjustments to string together a few stops.
And the rejection by Antetokounmpo. And stolen by Lillard. Pass to Lehman. The shot missing. Great D that time from Middleton. Here's Antetokounmpo. It's blocked.
He's good at leaping up to block shot, Kevin. And Aminu's vertical leap helps him big time in the defense.
And it's McCollum off the drive. It's over Brogdon. They get it again. And the rejection by Antetokounmpo. And Middleton kicks to Brogdon. Over McCollum. Milwaukee, no good that time either.
He gets the shot he was looking for and just can't bury it.
And for Yusuf Nurkic, you see the flashes of how dominant he can be in every game.
I mean, the potential is there, and he is working hard to find that consistency. I do believe he's noticeably better when he plays with an edge. He's more in tune with what's going on. You almost want to rile him up or do something to tick him off before every game to get the best out of him.
Now, gentlemen, two shots. Move shots.
No good on that one. Ilyasova, he's checked in for Milwaukee. And the second free throw, good. The clear strength of the Blazers is their backcourt of Lillard and McCollum.
Two complementing each other so well. Both can create and dish for one another. Both can take over a game with their shooting, and they're the engine that drives this whole offense.
Now, here's Antetokounmpo. 26 points for him last game against Sacramento.
And while he was doing that, I mean, dropping buckets, he was keeping everybody else involved, too. I mean, he had a tremendous night facilitating.
The Bucks shooting their first free throws of the evening.
And at the line last season, about 78% as a team. Pretty solid numbers.
That's good from Antetokounmpo.
And really, the ceiling for Antetokounmpo is limitless. I mean, he has the potential to be a Hall of Famer one day.
Both free throws good from Antetokounmpo. Trailblazers trail by six. Lillard outside. McCollum kicks to Aminu. Back to McCollum. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass.
And it's encouraging whenever McCollum scores inside, proving that he's more than just a jump shooter.
Here's Lopez. And a great assist by Bledsoe as that one goes in. Lopez has got his first 2 points of the night. And here's Lillard. He brings it up for the Portland Trail Blazers. They're getting their first look of the season at the Bucks in this one.
And as good as a team as they were a year ago, they hated seeing these guys in their meetings. Just couldn't get it done against them.
Bucks leading by six. Bledsoe outside. Here's Antetokounmpo. No good on the shot. A bit long that time.
The inside just a bit too congested for him to get the usual shot he would have with rhythm.
Here's Lehman. Antetokounmpo defending. Shot clock at six. And that one's good. Lillard.
Love how assured Lillard is for his spot. He's a confident shooter. He likes pulling up from anywhere.
Rodman kicks to Ilyasova. 1:58 left to play in the first. Whistle blows. Yep, that's going to be a travel. Now we'd like to take this moment to show you the teams that a year ago made a trademark of scoring points off turnovers. The Bucks second.
And they turned all those mistakes into points at the other end. That aggressive style really yielding big dividends.
So timeout called here, the first for Portland. And the dunk is always the king of the highlight reel. We know it comes easy if you're 6'10 or bigger, but Chris, there are little guys who can get up there and slam it down hard too.
Well, I tell you what, Westbrook absolutely scares me when he dunks the ball, because Westbrook thinks he's 7 foot tall and tries to dunk like it every time. So I love watching him attack the rim. How about Dennis Smith Jr.? His miss in the dunk contest last year was one of the most exciting dunks I've seen in a long time.
It was.
Eric Bledsoe, Terry Rozier. I mean, these guys, they attack the rim fearlessly, and they're going to posterize you if you're a big fella and sleeping on their hops.
So Portland ends up going with the new group. Milwaukee making a switch here.
And let's check out some stats for Turner. How he performed last season. Averaged about 8 points a game, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists. And the numbers won't wow you, but I like the effort he brings to the table each and every night.
He hustles, does the little things. Just a good complimentary guy who you need on your team.
Here's Bledsoe after the made shot from Evan Turner. Is inside the line. Again, the Trailblazers score.
Turner has great awareness. He knows one of his guys is open. He gets the pass over to him quickly.
Onezo kicks to Ilyasova. Over. the 9-foot shot. Portland grabs the miss. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing under control.
Down low. Now here's Harkless. Defense right on him. A miss that time would have put him up. Milwaukee's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. To the left wing. 30 seconds left in the first quarter. Back to Ilyasova. It's stolen by Stauskas. From the arc. Eric Bledsoe with the rebound. And now running up the court. Bledsoe pushing it up. Trying to get something going. That one doesn't go. It's all tied in Portland. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter number two. Well, there are a lot of letters that go into the spelling of Giannis Antetokounmpo's last name. He helped set the record straight of how you pronounce it.
In the Greek way, you gotta say it with a D, so it's Antetokounmpo. But in the Greek way, you say it with an NT, like Antetokounmpo. Whatever you got, just say, you know, it's Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Seems easy enough, right?
I guess so. I think a lot of people are gonna stick with Giannis or the Greek Freak.
And this has been a fairly close game through the first quarter, and we'll see what happens here in the second. And taking a look at the Trail Blazers' performance here, boys, what do you think they're doing or not doing?
Getting high percentage looks, wearing down that defense on the inside.
Right, and as the defense collapses, that opens up inside out opportunities. Productive first quarter.
On the court for Milwaukee here in the second, Middleton and Ilyasova holding down the forward spots. Then it's John Henson, then there's Bledsoe. No good on the free throw. Terry Stotts, the head coach for the Blazers, he has earned the trust of this roster.
Yeah, if you talk to the players on his team, Kevin, they believe in the system that he runs. He is always willing to give players a chance to earn minutes and is up front with them. Playing under Stotts, you know that if you work hard and improve, he'll take notice and adjust the rotations accordingly.
And he's good on the second. Portland trailing here. Outside Turner. He kicks to Leonard. Outside Curry. Three-pointer connects from three-point range.
And a good job taking what the D gives him. He's not going to pass it up with that much space.
Bledsoe finds Henson. Middleton outside. Lock at six. Shoots over Turner. And the wide-open shot from Bledsoe. And count it from 19 feet away. Bledsoe's got it all tied up now for the Bucks. And here's Curry, who brings it up for Portland. Pass to Stauskas. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Stauskas has got his second basket of the night.
I mean, this D is a joke. It's way too passive. They got to get a body on him when he's on his way to the bucket.
Henson the pass to Bledsoe. No good. That puts him at 2 for 6. Trailblazers shooting around 40% from the floor here. Stauskas kicks to Leonard. On the wing, Turner. There's the steal. DiVincenzo lays it in off the breakaway. We're now about 2 minutes into the second quarter. Here's Stauskas. Taking a look at the scoring numbers. Right now he averages about 9 points a game. The pass to Ilyasova. And here's Middleton, defended by Harkless. Middleton dishes to Bledsoe. IT that time from Leonard.
Well, he hasn't been very precise at all.
Curry on the wing. Guarded by Bledsoe. And the officials call him for a three-second violation. The Trailblazers making a switch here. McCollum's checked in. The Bucks also changing it up. Giannis Antetokounmpo's checked in for Ilyasova. And Brogdon subbed in for Eric Bledsoe. The Bucks have gone 2 of 5 from the field here in the second quarter, shooting 40%. Brogdon with it. And Curry picks him up defensively. McCollum against Middleton. Henson in the corner. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here's Antetokounmpo. He sinks the 11-footer. Antetokounmpo's got 6.
And after that ragged first quarter, they're getting some momentum, some confidence. Nice flow.
Harkless kicks to Curry. A shot. That shot missing. The Bucks go the other way with it.
And Malcolm Brogdon, the son of a lawyer and a college dean, no less. His maturity and thoughtfulness certainly reflect that upbringing.
Now, here's Antetokounmpo. 6 points for him. Now, here's Brogdon, defended by Harkless. The shot by Brogdon, no good. And for Portland, they're shooting 38% from the field. A pretty weak showing for them. And with the way Brogdon conducts himself, some teammates call him, Greg, the president.
Yeah, he has an air about him. He has that leadership quality and has a goal to create an NGO to alleviate poverty and hunger in developing nations. Who knows? Politics might not be out of the question for this young man.
An almost entirely new group here for Portland. Collins checked in for Myers Leonard. Aminu comes in for Maurice Harkless. Jake Lehman's checked in for Evan Turner. And Lillard subbed in for Seth Curry. Lopez, he's checked in for the Bucks. Tony Snell comes in for Chris Middleton. And Lillard kicks to Collins. To the middle. And trying for the go-ahead basket. It doesn't go in. Brogdon against McCollum. Bounce pass from Brogdon. 1:27 left in the first half of the game. DiVincenzo, covered by Lillard. And again, the Bucks miss. Trailblazers have gone 3 of their first 5 shots to drop here in the second quarter. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum. Lillard's got the lead up to 2 now for the Trailblazers. Antetokounmpo against Aminu. Antetokounmpo picks to Brogdon. Passes it to Lopez. And he uses the glass on the layup. Lopez has got it all tied up now for Milwaukee.
The main area of expertise for Lopez, I mean, he's excellent at finding ways to cash in from there.
Tries from 16. Milwaukee with the rebound. Antetokounmpo's got 4 rebounds in this game. 26 seconds left to play here in the half. Kicks it to Lopez. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Trailblazers will take. And so Lillard will bring it up for Portland. To the wing right side. Here's Lehman. So a tie game here as we finish the first half. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Coach Terry Stotts. Coach, it's a hard game so far. Going into the second half, what will you tell your team?
We just got to compete. You know, keep competing, trust each other, and make plays.
All right, Coach, thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to 2K Sports, the Halftime Show. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Boy, we have a lot to discuss. The first quarter for the Trailblazers was fairly even. Nothing seemed to give way on either side of the scoring column as they wrapped up the period all knotted up. The second quarter was dead even in terms of their scoring output from both teams, and they still find themselves in a good position at the half. Shaq, how do you think the Trailblazers were playing?
You know, they haven't shot the ball very well. Not nearly enough quality looks. Right now, this game could easily come down to shot selection and how they run their offense. They need to keep the ball moving and generate better looks.
And over to Kenny, your thoughts on the Bucks?
I was surprised on how comfortable they seemed here on the road. The hostile crowd, that didn't bother them at all. And I want to see if they can keep that up in the second half.
And that's a wrap. With the third quarter approaching, we now send you back to Kevin and the crew.
Welcome back to Portland, a fine-looking day in this terrific-looking city. And as we get into this third quarter, as we've seen so far, neither team able to create much separation on the scoreboard yet. You have to like what we're seeing from Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Yeah, the effort and intensity from a defensive standpoint has just really been superb, really firing up his team.
Oh, yeah, and in the first half, he was not only changing shots, he was sending them back into the crowd.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. Lillard and McCollum, the deadly backcourt pairing. Al-Farouq Aminu is out there with Nurkic, and it's Lehman in at the three, the small forward. That's the group on the floor for Portland. Trailblazer shooting has been a little ragged, just 38% from the field. Inside. Aminu finds Lillard. Hits the three-point bomb. Lillard's got the first bucket of the third here for the Trailblazers. See, we have a quick tactical question here. As a big, when you're defending the pick and roll, what are the things you're looking to do? How do you handle that?
Okay, I'm going to try to rapid pace this because this is what goes through your mind. What did Coach say to shoot? Wait a minute, who is this? Is this Steph Curry that can dribble, or is this Thompson that loves to take a step back? Or is it a player like Durant that loves to hit you with the step back? Or who's setting the pick? Is it a guy like Thompson that's going to slip? Or is it a guy like Dwight Howard that they can throw it up to? Is it Capella that may slip and go through and you still throw it up to him? You can't get back. Who's communicating? Wow. Who's on my team in the corner? What shooter's in the corner? Because they can't leave the corner to come help. Do I hedge hard? Do I not hedge hard? Oh, no, this is the NBA's the greatest players in the world, and even if you do it right, they're going to score anyway. That's kind of the worst thing.
That is something else. For Milwaukee, they have gone 3 of 4 at the free throw line tonight.
Shooting two.
The first free throw is good. Free throws good from Antetokounmpo. Portland leading. Lillard with it. 7 points in the game. Pass to Nurkic. Dishes to McCollum. Shoots over Brogdon. Again, the Trailblazers good for two.
That makes three in a row to start the second half.
Wonzo kicks to Lopez. To the paint. Antetokounmpo.
Look, and when someone's open, Lopez will find them, using his height to see over the defense.
The Trailblazers have gone 3 of 3 from the field since halftime. Pass to McCollum. And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. Lillard misses.
That's how you protect the rim. Stand your ground and make him alter his release.
And last season, not the one Brook Lopez wanted to have before heading into free agency.
He just never seemed to find a place with the Lakers and saw his minutes decline as he wasn't in their plans. Averaged a career low in terms of minutes played per game last year. And I think he still's got a lot to offer and should bounce back closer to his all-star level of output.
Now a timeout called by Portland. And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
Not quite 2.5 minutes played here in the second half. Here's Stauskas. Just 5 on the clock. Nurkic, solid play in the low block, and that one's good. Nurkic has got his first basket of the night.
That makes him 4 for 5. I mean, I think that's pretty good numbers. I mean, they've got to be pleased with how things are playing off so far.
Now here's Bledsoe. 5 points in the game. Outside, out of the Kumbo. Back to Bledsoe. Over Curry. And again, it's Milwaukee converting. This game has a lot of character here in the third period. 6 changes of the lead here.
Intensity is the theme for this one.
Here's Stauskas. Outside Curry. Launches it. The rebound by Brogdon.
And you don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
Here's Antetokounmpo, and the call will be against Jusuf Nurkić. That's his first foul. Collins checked in for the Trailblazers. Collins against Ilyasova. Here's Snell. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Just 4 to shoot. And yes, it's good.
And with their hot shooting here in the second half, their field goal percentage over 50% now for the game.
Turner looking around. And that one hits back iron.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot he has to continue to take.
Now, here's Antetokounmpo. He's got 14. Outside for Bledsoe. Here's Snell. Turner covering. Snell, the pass to Bledsoe. From outside the arc, Evan Turner pulls it in. Turner's got 4 rebounds now tonight.
He's been off target for the most part, but it hasn't held them back as a unit.
Curry against Bledsoe. Right side Curry. Back to Stauskas. Outside for Curry. Knocks down the 3-ball. Curry's got the game tied up here for the Trailblazers.
That's too much space to give him out there on the perimeter. They got to close out on him.
Now here's Antetokounmpo. D right on him. And he gets the bucket. Antetokounmpo's got 10 points in just the second half.
Well, he's reason number one there in front. I mean, his shooting has been almost flawless.
The pass to Turner. Ilyasova against Collins. Curry is inside. Here's the 3. Curry with another miss.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the 3. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
And so it's Turner with it. He brings it up for Portland. Trailing by 2, Curry gets the bucket.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
And here is Antetokounmpo over Harkless. No good there off the double clutch. And we just finished the third quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. Trailblazers lead by 1. From Portland, we're back in a moment. Terry Stotts had some advice for his team. Let's hear what he had to say.
Look, we're struggling. The ball's not going. Keep being aggressive, getting it out. Defensively, keep challenging shots. All right, keep talking. Everything's good down there. Way to rebound the ball. I love the tempo. Love the pace. All right, once we get it, we go. Make or miss.
Well, he knows the ball's going to start falling sooner or later.
And, Kevin, it's just been one of those games offensively. They just got to continue to persevere, and hopefully a few will fall.
And I know I speak for all of us when I say I can't wait to see what kind of finish awaits us here in the fourth quarter. On the floor for Milwaukee, starting the fourth quarter. Brook Lopez is out there with John Henson. Then there's Bledsoe. Then there's Tony Snell. Passes to Bledsoe. Lopez against Leonard. DiVincenzo. A three-pointer is right on target.
It seems like they found their rhythm offensively, and they're shooting the ball much better out of the break.
Leonard looking over the floor. And here's McCollum for three. Rebound collected by Snell. Milwaukee in the lead. To the inside, DiVincenzo. And a missed layup.
I like the burst to the bucket right there, but the finish has got to be better.
And for Milwaukee, they're shooting reasonably well, 45%. Lillard against Bledsoe. He kicks it to Henson. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist. Now it's a four-point Bucks lead. Portland's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. McCollum dishes to Leonard. McCollum outside. Pass to Aminu. Beyond the arc. That falls. Nice feed that time from McCollum. McCollum's got his third assist on the night. The Bucks have gone 2-of-3 from the field to get the fourth quarter start. Now a timeout called by Milwaukee.
But just watching the progression of C.J. McCollum year to year has been astonishing. I mean, he came into the NBA with little fanfare, but now he's one of the league's top shooting guards.
Yusuf Nurkić, he's checked in for Myers Leonard. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, guys. Well, Mike Budenholzer had some advice for the team during the timeout, and he's pushing them to empty the tank. He said, I know you're tired and it's been a tough game, but we can't hold back. If you're tired, come out. Otherwise, I want you full speed, guys.
Now, here's Antetokounmpo. That one's not going to go.
Oh, great effort there. That's how you defend the paint.
Yeah, he has that capacity. He knows exactly where to position himself to protect the rim.
And with McCollum, he is the complete package on the offensive end.
I mean, he can take any defender one-on-one, and with a little bit of space, he can take over the game. He's a great shooter and fantastic facilitator. I mean, you ask around the league, they'll tell you that McCollum is one of the toughest guys to guard on the wing.
Now, here's Bledsoe. Down low. And Antetokounmpo with the basket on the assist from Eric Bledsoe. Antetokounmpo has got 12 points here in the second half. Trailblazers trail by three. Three-pointer, Lillard. Offensive rebound. And Middleton with the block. And he gets it back. And there's the basket. Whistle blows and a chance for a three-point play. Going to the line for one. One drops, he ties it up.
And we've seen just how incredible McCollum can be when he is feeling it. One of the few guards in the league who gets everything to fall when his shot is on. It's why he can just erupt with huge scoring nights at any given time.
Now, here's Brogdon. Kicks to Antetokounmpo. And a great assist by Brogdon as that one goes in. And that's 20 points for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Lillard against Bledsoe. goes up the baseline. Here's Nurkic. Goes to the reverse layup and traps it in.
Oh, this is what you want from Nurkic, a fearless player who welcomes the chance to take important shots.
For Milwaukee, they've gone 4 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. And with McCollum's explosiveness, Greg, you recall he put up 50 points in a game last season.
And how about he did so in under 30 minutes of floor time? McCollum, only the second player to ever achieve that mark. Helps he started with a 28-point first quarter, but he is locked in. He can put up points like nobody's business.
Gotta like how calm McCollum is, even in big parts of the game. You can depend on him to step his game.
Timeout called, the Bucks. They're behind by 3. And there's a minute 45 left in the fourth quarter. And now we get the chance to present our Jordan player of the game, C.J. McCollum.
And he's played this entire game on his front foot, Kevin. I mean, driving the lane, going to the rim with purpose, and getting those points the hard way.
And there's a minute 45 left to play here in the fourth. Back to Bledsoe. Here's Antetokounmpo. And again, the Bucks miss. Trailblazers leading by 3. McCollum kicks to Layman. Lillard, the pass to Layman. 6 to shoot. Stolen by Middleton. Here's Antetokounmpo, and the layup is good after a nice lead pass. Antetokounmpo's got 6 points in the quarter.
Yeah, beautiful play on the interior. They're just using the height advantage to lay the ball up and in when they really need it that much.
Now, here's Lillard, and the whistle blows. It's going to be on Chris Middleton. That's his 3rd foul of the game. There's 57 seconds left in the fourth quarter. A 3 from McCollum. That shot misses. And Milwaukee will come the other way. Middleton fine, touches Kumbo. A shot off that time.
That's what we're talking about in terms of the activity level defensively. You got to protect the rim.
Well, that takes physical ability, good timing. Those 2 things that he possessed.
Count it!
Now, that is cold-blooded.
We want people to tune in, don't we? This is what they're tuning in to. Big moments.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. They trail by 1. 29 seconds left in the fourth. Outside. Some nice ball movement here by the Trailblazers. 5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Lillard against Bledsoe. McCollum right side. 5 to shoot. It's good!
Timeout.
And that was so clutch. I mean, they're in front by the slimmest of margins, in need of a stop right here.
Timeout called, the Bucks. They're trailing by 1. There's 10 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Guys, what's your take?
And really, no need to rush. Still plenty of time to get a good look.
Yeah, and this is the time to run the best play they got. I mean, the one set they've been holding on to all game. Now's the time to break it up.
Bledsoe kicks to Adetokunbo. Oh, no good. And so the big win by Portland in a tight game. That was a fun night of basketball and fabulous finish as they continued to wait out until the very last moment to seal.
And there are so many times when you see these tight games won at home, that advantage of having that crowd behind you oftentimes is the ultimate X factor.
And that about wraps it up. For Greg Anthony, Chris Weber, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. We'll see you later.